Here I am at my own alma mater, Wartburg College. I'm standing underneath the historic building of Old Main, which was built in 1880 and was actually the first building that was ever constructed here on Wartburg's Waverly campus. The college itself has actually had a few different homes over the last 150 years, but today on the Waverly campus, it's homecoming and there's a lot of energy, so let's go have some fun. What's great about Wartburg is that even on a rainy day, you can still see the campus. Almost every building on campus is connected with a skywalk. Now, I'm here with Renee. Renee and I went to Wartburg together, and now she's here as the Assistant Alumni Director. Is that right,
Renee?
That's
correct, yeah.
So tell me what it is that you like about Wartburg and Waverly. What is it?
You know, Wartburg, it just has this family environment, and I just felt when I was here as a student, I just fit, and then to come back, I still fit. It's just a tight-knit community, mm-hmm. and you'll see that throughout this whole weekend. We're having probably 2,000 to 3,000 people at least come back that are alumni from all over the United States.
And now, what about Waverly? Why do you think that Waverly is so important to the Wartburg community?
I think just that small-town feel kind of helps, but I think that Waverly really supports Wartburg, and Wartburg really supports Waverly.
Awesome. Well, Renee, it was great to see you, and best of luck over the weekend.
Thank
you'll be seeing me out and about. So
it's going to be a wild weekend, but lots of fun.
Well, that's Grossman Hall. It's where I used to live when I attended Wartburg, and spent a whole lot of time studying there. New to Wartburg's campus this year is the W. It houses an indoor track, a swimming pool, and it's open to Waverly residents and Wartburg students. Let's go check it out. Wow. 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 This is a pretty sweet arena. Well, I gotta tell you, this place is awesome. If this had been around when I was going to school, maybe I would have spent more time exercising and less time studying. Well, I'm here outside the McElroy Communication Arts Center where I spend a lot of time Wait a second, that joke doesn't even make any sense. I did study in there. Let's go see if my old advisor's around.
This building hosts Wartburg Television, the college TV station that delivers news about the Wartburg and Waverly area.
All right, well, I'm here in the McElroy Communication Arts Center with my old advisor and author of Making Waves, People and Places of Iowa Broadcasting, Dr. Jeff Stein. Dr. Stein, good to see you.
Good to see you.
Always a pleasure. Thank you very much. It's good to be back. This place has changed so much since I've been here. You mind showing us around a little bit, seeing what's changed?
We're going into the studio, and one of the things that was interesting about the studio is it used to be the choir room. So anybody who went to Wartburg College in the 60s, 70s, 80s, this was half the choir room. And what we tried to do was to create a backdrop that was as versatile as possible. For example, these backdrops that are orange are what we use for sports.
Mm-hmm, okay.
But they are hung on hooks, they're panels, and we can swap them out. And so instead of an orange panel, there might be a blue panel.
Okay.
So when we're doing our news programs, everything is blue. When we're doing the sports, we turn them into orange. And so what we're teaching the students is from a branding standpoint.
Mm-hmm.
If you watch and you see these pillars, you know it's our channel,
mm-hmm.
but the color tells you it's a different program.
Okay.
And we have a huge television monitor that usually is pivoted out here so that you stand in front of mm-hmm. it. We've tried to make it as close to what you would have in a commercial station as possible.
Well, I was going to say, this desk is pretty fancy, a lot better than the one that was here. People watching may well be familiar.
This is what was in KCCI in Des Moines.
Oh, okay.
For about 12 years.
Okay,
the paint was a little different color, but you know, this desk alone has history because any major event in Des Moines, you know, from the floods of 93 through 9/11 to, you know, anything, this is where, you know, Kevin Cooney and all these folks would sit. Come around. And
do
I want you to sit right here.
All right.
Okay, right at this mark.
At this mark right here. Okay.
Now, you now know exactly what it feels like to be Steve Carlin.
Because
this
is
exactly where he would sit to do the 5 o'clock.
I love Steve Carlin. Steve Carlin is great. I love that guy.
The idea is that we want the students to produce high-quality programs that look like, quote, real TV, because we really think we are real TV.
Sure, definitely.
And what it says for a program, though, of this size is, we can't. We're too small to do everything really, really well. Mm-hmm. But we do television and radio well. We do the sciences well, natural sciences. We do business administration and a lot of other things. But when you can really focus on having this asset, the students take care of it, so you get ownership.
Just talk to me a little bit about being in Waverly, and, you know, do you feel that the community appreciates the service you guys provide here at the college through the broadcasting program?
You know, I really think we do, and our mayor once said to a group that one of the assets is they try to bring people to the community, and they were just listing things. You know, we have parks, we have this, whatever. He said, we have our own local television station, because WTV8 is based at Wartburg College, but it covers the community. It's a great resource. It's helped people recover from disasters like the floods. It helps them learn about good, positive things. It's really something that I think the community does take pride in, and our students go out in the field and they get recognized. You know, and that's a great thing, because if you're going to be in television, it's going to happen. And then that's validation of their work when they actually have somebody come up and say, didn't I see you on TV? You do a really nice job. And you're on cloud nine the rest of the day.
And you know, I want to thank you for taking us through all the new facilities and everything. It's great to be back here. And, you know, it feels like I never left almost getting back in here. So
the registrar wants to talk to you about some credits that are outstanding. But other than that, no, it's great for you to be back and to be so successful in what you're doing. If we had anything to do with it, we'll take that.
Well, thank you very much, Dr. Stein.
You bet.